All right, what is it, the 21? You, okay, intensified, and intensified, detensifying. The last few days I've been wearing red, and it's heavy and thick, and it's like, you know, like the cardinal bird, you know, you see this cardinal bird, and it's like, what's the deal? He has to wear that red every day of his life. So perhaps, you know, I'm like, okay, energy, I have to bring the energy down because it's too heavy, it's too thick, it's too intense. So I'm like, okay, well, for weeks and weeks I wear this lapis. I just found out this morning it's a lapis. I'm very terrible with my stone names, but yeah, it's a lapis. And I'm like, this is going to center me, right, cool me off, you know, put me on the dark side of the moon. You know, the dark side of the moon is that place where it's just like, yeah, you don't have to even think of anything really, just an empty away. So it hasn't worked. The lapis didn't work. With the red. The red itself surpassed the lapis. So sorry about that. Lapis stone. Really like it though. Really like it. I put black on with the lapis also. And that is not working. So here I am now. I'm just okay. There's more of the nudie there, and that's not working. Well, no, it is working, but what? Yeah, feeling a little tense here, Yeah, and so I'm thinking of the cardinal bird and. That flight, maybe better in the afternoons, late, maybe in the mornings only, you know, not when it's too bright. Maybe that's a problem with red. I mean, red itself is kind of a bright overdone, isn't it? Yeah, this color thing has really got me going. What's the other deal? Red itself. Yeah, the cars, red cars. Don't drive your red car in the middle of the day in the heat of the sunshine. It's too much. Yeah. It's too dramatic. It's too intense. Yeah. I don't know. I'm not really going anywhere with these videos lately. Just being. Eaten alive by color. Yeah. So, yeah, pink is no good. Red is a fail. Lapis isn't saving me. Oh, I know, so. Red, go away. Maybe that's why redheads are so unpopular, actually. You know, maybe that's why. One of the reasons. Anyway. Oh my gosh! I just stabbed myself in the head. Now I'm so clumsy. So when because I'm so clumsy right now at the moment. Oh gosh. It's like, I don't know. I have coffee. Oh, I guess so. A remnant of burn. I have a remnant of burn here. So that'll be a remind. What red does. Heat burns things. Burn my point shoes there. Look at that. Singe them all the way through. They have that, you know. Stupid situation. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna heat these suckers up and put that, I don't know, furniture glue or whatever in there, and just torch, you know, my shoes. So that's no good, is it? It's no good. Yeah. So the deal is with red, Orange, yeah, be careful with those colors, people, or pinks, gosh dang. It's odd too, because you see like a lot of young girls, they're into like pink hearts and all of that, you know. You know, when you're like 12 and 13 years old and you're like looking at Hello Kitties or whatever, little pink ponies. Yeah, what's all that about? That young budding stage of romance is in that color frame, isn't it? Yeah, they really go for it. All that innocence. Yeah. What was that? I just saw a picture today. Gosh dang. You know, and it's that stab that, like, when you hit yourself, it just stays there. God dang. No, there was that, yeah. There's no humor allowed with red intensity either. Red intensity just doesn't even allow humor. It's that gross, you know. It's that gross of an overtake. I can't stand it. So now, where was I? Yeah, there was this pink. Apparently, it was called a snowball. It was some hostess item. But there's a festival that happens in a woman's life, a young woman's life, 15 or 16, in Mexico, and they get these dresses on there. And I saw one this morning, and she's wearing this pink snowball dress, and it was just really, really funny. Yeah, it's hysterical. And yeah, that was just like that, the pink parade, you know. It's almost like keep her in it, you know, just keep her in it, keep her in the pink, you know, like forever. Keep her in that that frame of space. Yeah. Well, they're not wearing red at that time frame, are they? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I should ban the color red around me. It's unfortunately, it's like my greatest jacket that I've ever had, you know, fits on my waist pretty well. Not my greatest, but no, you know, it's not black, color-wise. It's a pretty good one anyway. But dang, you know, I can't wear that right now. What is it about, you know, is this intensity need at this stage in my life? That's where it starts to look like. It's like, hurry up, have intensity before you're dead. Because without the blood red friction of its flow, you're going to be like just grayed, you know, just going to be grayed into the stream of never none, you know, never none. Nothing, you know, just existing, just the end, you know, just each day dwelling upon itself from the last, you know, it's just going to be an extraordinary week, just like last week's extraordinary week. So much you're like, well, I think I've already tasted that bagel, I've already had that croissant, I don't want to ever again. Can you burn them this time? For hell's sakes, can you just goddamn burn the croissants? What is that? Life again? You asked for life again? You asked for life again. No. No. So that's the opulence of red. Yeah, I'm missing and everything, you know, like this, is there a red fish? Come on, is there a red fish? Let's think about the fishes in the deep blue sea. We have out there, my gosh. Well, we have those betas, those ones, they're always fighting. That's not a good example. What else? What other kind of fish is red? Gosh dang. Can't even come up with any. There's the lion one. It's kind of orange. And then there's the other. Yeah. red tail, the red tail shark. And there's parrots, you know, got all those parrots. Yeah, the macaws. Oh gosh, yeah, red. Oh, well, maybe that's the answer. I need chalk. I'm lacking in chalk. I need to nibble on some chalk, just like the macaw. That'll fix me. Yeah, I don't know. It's good for them, isn't it? It's some kind of a calcium contributant or something. I don't know. Extra mineral organization. Calm them down. Bring vibrancy in. Probably so they're not out flocking around at the wrong hours. Maybe life is like that. You know, you have. You know, the morning, day, sun, wake, and then you have, you know, during, out, and it's just like, well, maybe they are only flying specific times for a reason, you know, an attunement and all of this, getting in tune with life. Maybe they're only flying for a particular reason. You know, maybe the day itself is lacking red, and it just has to become that painter's brush, that wand that just strokes over the day. You know what I'm saying? Maybe that's what nature's all about. Was supposed to be anyway, until it becomes out of balance and out of sync because of you know, too much one side take over another. But yeah, could very well be their original plan. There is for that red macaw to have its flight, just like a painting, a beautiful painting's moment. Yeah, and the same with the blue, you know, same deal with the blue. Yeah, it's tough when I'm digging in here to this stone, because this is from the earth ground, you know, it's from the earth ground self, and it's just like, well, it's because it's from the earth ground, I'm kind of cheating by even wearing it. It's nothing to do, but I'm not going to wear a macaw around my neck. So, a blue one. But yeah, I guess they do probably take those feathers, don't they? They probably take their feathers as some kind of a value. Yeah. Well, anyway. I was dealing with the dark side of the moon, yeah. And, yeah, it's a good decompression song. I'll give it that. I'm a little nervous here, and yet I'm still drinking coffee. So yay.